following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Hi, this is Ken Gage, and this is the Out of Politics Look. Last week, I told Al Baldessaro I would eat a crow if Trump won.
And God bless America.
Would eat a crow also if Trump won, lost. But I'm not going to eat a crow. We can't find a crow. He killed a pigeon. I'm not eating a pigeon. So he's going to sacrifice his parakeet. He's going to sacrifice his parakeet, and I'm going to eat it. His parakeet. That's how much of a weird guy this is. In fact, he's not here today simply because he can't get his head through the door. John Burt, how
yes,
are you?
Very well, thank you.
Hoosier?
Our famous Bart Fromuth from representative
yes,
from
That's right. And
Bedford.
You're from?
Bedford.
Bedford. And yes. You're from?
Goffstown.
Okay, say hi to Bedford.
Hi, Bedford. How are you doing?
Say hi to Goffstown.
Hi, Goffstown.
Hi, Goffstown.
Yes.
You got to do a little more than that.
Well, I was just happy that the voters, and thank you, voters.
How bad did you beat this person?
Should I say the number?
Yeah, go ahead.
2,817 votes.
That's a lot.
That's a lot. It's Evelyn Connor, real nice lady. She probably sat with you last time in 12.
Excuse
14, in 14.
Excuse me, 2,800.
14.
Yeah.
Right. I beat her by 1,100.
And, you know, I really believe Trump when he says things are crooked. That's for sure. What did you win by? What did you lose by?
I beat my Democratic opponent by 1,600 votes.
Wow.
Or, sorry, 1,400. 1,400, I apologize.
Oh, yeah. 14. So, that's still good.
So, and you came in what?
I came in sixth out of the Republicans. So.
I always come in first, but what happened was they always run three Republicans. Now, this is, you got to remember, this is an election. This is a, you know, the big election, so everybody gets out. They run one Republican.
Well, is there three Republicans in your town?
Oh, yes.
There is?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. This is Nashville. What do you think? There's no Republicans? You got one in there. You got two here.
Well, we're visiting.
You're passing
by. Yeah, we're
visitors.
Yeah, we're just
right.
Going through the highway.
Right.
Unfortunately, we can't vote in your town.
So he wins by, beats me by 13 votes. Now, I lost fair and square. I came in second. But I said, what?
Well, you,
and
you,
most of, I mean, in other words, so many Republicans voted for me. He's lucky he, 13 votes.
Well, do you think that the 13 votes has to do where he put his unattended sign?
We went through that. No. Oh. Did you, all right, wait a minute. The election is over, obviously.
Yes.
Minority Trump won.
Yes.
And minority means he lost by 1 million people more. Had voted, no, it's more than that, voted for Hillary Clinton. That was 2 days ago. You got to watch TV. You don't watch TV, do you?
A little bit.
All right. So he wins the presidency, and she gets 1 million more votes.
Well,
so
she's
the minority president. What?
She won California by 2 million votes. That's why she carried the popular vote.
Well, so what?
Well, you know, I just
don't you think one
I
point?
Just don't think your cousin's in California.
But Ken,
do you really
Ken.
Think Al should kill his parakeet?
No.
I mean, he's going to do away with
this. Little,
but
that's
can
a cute.
Can I ask you a question?
Well,
this is. I want to get you on the record. We're talking to folks right now. But I've heard the Electoral College versus the popular vote now for about a week. Okay, and it just sounds like sour grapes to me.
Yes,
because
it is.
your party uses the superdelegate system to choose your nominee. Can you comment on that for John, myself, and our friends in Nashua as to why that's...
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, how about...
Because Bernie he destroyed Hillary.
72%.
And then somehow didn't win the state.
That's right. Excuse me. Why don't we look at it this way? I will agree he's president because of electoral votes.
Oh, you will?
Oh, absolutely.
Well, we were all waiting for you to do that.
He lost the person vote, one vote, one person, by 1 million.
But don't
he does not have a majority. So if he thinks he's got, can run around and do all these things, he's not going to be able to do it.
Well, Ken.
Yes.
You know I like you. And I'm with you and I'm for you.
Every time somebody starts out like that.
So this is our safety pin. If you feel uncomfortable, Bart and I are here for you, for your safety pin.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I got a safety pin. I knew something was going to happen. I got a safety pin from these guys. All right.
Now, do you want to explain the safety pin
why aren't you wearing
the
safety
few pin? That doesn't understand what the safety pin
explain,
is.
No, explain it.
I guess the Democrats are starting to wear safety pins for safety.
So it just means, as you said, so that if I'm walking down the street, I'm a Democrat.
With your feelings hurt.
And my feelings are hurt, and I've got my safety pin on, and you're walking down the street, and you've got your safety pin on. We're just silently communicating with one another that it's going to be okay. I'm here for you. I support you. And all is not lost.
I got a question. Can you see me with a safety pin?
I'm asking you
a question. Can you see me wearing a safety pin?
It's been a tough week for you.
Yes.
No, it hasn't. This is a great week, and I'll tell you why, because now you guys are on the other side. Yippee! This means I can really have some fun, and boy, can I bug that Al Baldessaro. And by the way, let's talk a little bit about Al.
God bless him.
Yeah, God bless. He's flying. When I say he couldn't get his head through the door, literally, he gets on this, he tweets, he's helped, saved the Lincoln Company from not going to...
Who, Al did?
Oh, yeah, he was part of the people.
Right, yeah.
The only problem was the Lincolns weren't moving. It was a small car division so they could put the big cars over there.
Oh, the Lincoln Car Company.
Yes.
The Ford Motor Company.
There you go, Ford Motor.
Well, but they're not moving now.
Yeah. No.
They're going to move to Mexico.
They're building another vehicle there. They put their small car division.
But if they build those cars in Mexico,
they can't do it.
Trump's going to slap a 35% tariff on them, so they're better off keeping them here.
Oh, you really think that can happen?
Trump hasn't even been sworn in yet, and he's already created jobs. I heard there is 2,000 Soros-paid employees protesting down at Trump Tower.
And you believe that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
You believe it? And of course,
why are they there?
Of course, you would not believe the gentleman on TV who said he was paid $3,500 to go around and start fights at Trump's rallies. You wouldn't believe that, would you?
Of course I believe that.
Yeah.
You'd believe that?
Yeah.
He's a Republican.
No, he's not.
A Trump person starting fights but he was paid.
Yeah, and that's wrong.
So it's wrong.
I don't care what party you are. If you're being paid to disrupt the other side, it's wrong.
You know what really gets me?
I'm for equality.
Yeah, I love you guys. What do you think happened as Obama was going for the first time to be president? What do you think happened?
Hillary viciously went after him.
Well, not only that, but there was a whole
remember
bunch
those terrible
of
photos
white
that Hillary,
supremacy.
Remember those terrible photos that Hillary's campaign leaked of Obama in Kenyan headgear?
Yes.
To try to insinuate he wasn't somehow from this country? Started the birther movement, I believe.
She did.
Well, it's one thing about headgear, and it's another thing about what your president has on top of his head. What the hell is that?
His hair.
I'd love to have that hair.
Yeah, it's great hair.
Excuse me.
It's very fashionable.
I don't even know how
he does it. I'd love to figure it out.
Yeah, it looks like a Manhattan traffic jam. I mean, come on now.
Hey, I'd trade.
Right. No, you wouldn't trade.
Yeah, I'd give Donald Trump my hair and I'll take his.
He's goofy. We're talking about a guy who doesn't know anything.
Can you, just real quickly though, because we're straying from, I think, what the people
you're having
want to hear
fun.
About. I'm not having fun.
Yes,
Ken.
You are.
I'm learning right
You're
now.
Beating me. No, you're not learning.
I'm learning.
You're talking.
I'm learning. I want to know, just take me through your emotional state on Tuesday night.
Yes.
Let's start off around 5 o'clock, and then just make your way all the way at about 3 o'clock in the morning.
But you want me to start that?
No.
Because
it's
real quick.
I want to tell you something.
All right, tell us.
I want to tell you something. Do you remember Truman and Dewey? Oh, I wasn't born yet. I was born, but I couldn't vote, obviously.
I'm 56.
Okay. So Truman is running for the presidency, and this guy, Dewey, who is, very intellectual, and he's going out, and there are small crowds. Truman's taking a train across the country, and a reporter says, wait a minute, there's a problem here because there's 10,000 people here. This doesn't make any sense. So obviously, a lot of people thought Dewey was going to win, especially a newspaper, who published Dewey Wins. All right, that's what happened. It was that type of energy.
Yes.
It was that type of, let's go do it. When I heard that people went to Trump's places and there were no signs, they went out, designed them, and had them made.
Yes.
When you hear stuff like that, okay, all of a sudden, she's not doing as much. She's trying to just stay back a little, and I'm going, that ain't going to work. It's not going to work at all. And to be perfectly honest with you, I probably would have been more surprised that she won than she lost. How's that?
Well, and why did she?
I don't really mean it. But.
And why did she go to bed at night instead of coming out?
It was 3 o'clock in the morning.
That's the other thing I have a question for you. What's with the Democrat candidates lately when they lose elections not coming out and giving concession speeches?
Yes, yes.
Which one?
We have it here. I've got Hillary Clinton, and I've got McCain came out the next day. Can you imagine what they would have called him?
It's 3 o'clock in the morning.
Did she not have the stamina? Oh.
Yeah, maybe she wasn't. Yeah, she wasn't fit to be president.
Did she make a concession speech?
The next morning.
It was out at 3 in the morning?
Yeah, he did.
But why didn't Trump? What are you talking about? Why didn't Colin Van Ostern, with his fingers?
Why didn't Colin Van Ostern come out and give a concession speech?
Who?
The guy that was running for governor for your party.
I don't know. I didn't vote for him. I didn't vote.
Now it's on tape.
I did vote for him. I wouldn't vote for Sununu. I wouldn't vote for him. In fact, I think probably
that's who I voted for.
Conley should have been for the Democrats.
Oh yeah, well
this other guy was, kids and dogs, and it looks nice, and he's got the perfect everything.
Changed his name.
Yeah, and here's Sununu up there, scratching his head with skis coming down. Anyway.
You paint a terrible picture.
Having a father who was governor, worked with.
Well, now he's ready to run.
But why? It just shows, in my opinion, some poor sportsmanship. If you're not going to give a concession, look at all the people that went and held signs for Colin out in the cold weather, gave up time with their kids and their family.
Are you telling me he didn't?
He did not. He isn't. As of today, he has not given a concession speech.
I don't believe that.
I
can't believe
you owe me lunch up at Tandy's.
Okay.
If I'm wrong.
Okay. All right. What's the date? Time and date.
Today is what, the 17th?
17th.
18th?
Time. Let's see. 4:48.
And then you got this guy.
He didn't give it. No, really. Your Democrat nominee refused to give a concession speech. Well, I got to tell you a story. This is true.
Well, I got a third question.
I ran for political office. I lost. I didn't. I tried to call him. He had a private number. I swear to God.
Okay.
So I went and I saw him 2 weeks later, and I said, "Look, I tried to call you." But so was I a bad person?
But were you running for governor?
I had no idea what I was running for. Those were the days.
Obviously, in the lower ballot races.
No. Come on. That's not only poor sportsmanship. That's just foolish. Just an idiot. That's idiotic. You don't do that. Come on. I mean, if the next day, if he has written something really nice to say, hey, look, and I'm going to work with you and all this, as they
usually say, you owe your supporters a thanks for getting out there.
I absolutely agree with you.
I just chose a little bit of immaturity on his part, in my opinion. But again, he's taking a cue from the...
I agree. He's taking a cue from
Buckley. Buckley.
From who?
From Hillary, in my opinion. Hillary.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Who, Buckley?
Yeah.
Buckley. What Buckley?
Your leader.
Buckley, your leader.
He's not my leader, and I wish he'd go away.
He should.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the reasons why I'm going to get 8 seats, and maybe change my party is because of Ray Buckley. Ray Buckley, go away, will you? These people keep losing.
Yeah, no.
We want some winners.
So now I'm
join
agreeing
us.
With yes.
Join us.
Yes. So it's kind of scary that I'm agreeing with you here.
Yeah, this is amazing. I thought you were going to flip out. How could you vote for Trump and
yes.
this and that? And you're horrible. And then all of a sudden, there's all this agreement. There is hope for America today.
There is.
There's hope for America.
God bless
America.
There's
hope for New Hampshire.
You guys are really
fantastic.
You guys are really cocky, aren't you? I really love this. I'll give them a couple weeks, and then I'll really beat the hell out of them. But no, hey, look.
Safety pin.
Yeah, I know. You see me wearing a safety pin, right?
There's going to be a lot of them at the state house.
Hey, look. He, by all rights, mind-wise, okay, he is not capable. He has no. He look.
Who are we talking about now?
Okay, Trump. He.
The president.
Say President Trump. Minority President Trump. He complained about Hillary.
Who
with
did?
A secure, right?
Yep.
Computer thing. He's talking on his cell phone, unsecured phone, to world leaders.
But what is he talking?
Excuse me.
What is he talking?
And what
top
was on?
Secret?
And what was on yeah, her like, server?
The top FBI top. Guy says right. top secret
okay,
stuff.
Excuse me. That is wrong.
We're going to have an excellent opportunity to find out exactly what
well,
she's done
until
now.
He got threatened again. Because remember, he read what? In 8 days, he read 650,000
emails? 650,000
emails. And the reason he came back and said, yeah, there's nothing here. Because people end up
no,
dead.
No, wait, no, really. Well,
they
it,
do.
It, it
people
was an
end
algorithm.
Up dead
you
near
know
near
that,
Hillary.
For God's, it was an algorithm. You know that, for God's sakes. It could probably
wait,
do
wait,
it.
Wait, can I ask you a question?
And you want
what an algorithm had Loretta Lynch that, and Bill Clinton meeting on a tarmac in Arizona?
That is true.
What algorithm was that?
Yeah.
I don't know. He used to be a former president, and so what happened?
Right
well,
after that, they let him
right
let
after
Hillary
that, all
go.
Of a sudden,
you
Hillary got cleared
really
of all charges.
Think?
Yes,
well, wait
I
a minute.
Do. Yes, I think all the worst things when I see that.
Historically, now we can back up.
America took a big broom and just swept them all out of office because they were so disgusted with
thank
what
you.
They saw.
Thank you, America.
So thank you, Americans, because you saw the same things that we did.
Yeah.
That had us disheartened in the system, but now, thank God. Donald Trump is going to drain the swamp, and now Jeff Sessions is going to help him do it.
Listen. He just put a general in for national security.
Advisor.
And he wrote, okay, on a Twitter, not only is she so bad, but she was playing with children. Excuse me.
There is rumor, though.
How low can you go? There's not a rumor of that.
Your buddy.
There's
an Obama, your buddy, President Obama, 2 days before the vote was taken, said that if Donald Trump got elected president, that would bring the KKK back to prominence in the United States.
It has. Didn't you hear about a shoe company? A sneaker company. KKK came out and said, this is our sneaker. This is our, you know, our national sneaker. And the company's gone
bankrupt. You truly believe that the KKK has risen back to prominence?
They think so.
Well, and who started the KKK?
They think so.
And who started
it? The Democrats.
Yes.
During Reconstruction.
A Democrat started it?
During Reconstruction.
That's common knowledge.
Oh, you know, you guys.
That is true. I didn't even have to read that on Facebook.
But can you just at least concede that when Hillary Clinton shares emails with a known pedophile, Anthony Weiner,
yes,
on his laptop of ill repute, I might say, because God knows what he's doing on that laptop, and we got national security emails on the laptop.
I have some bad news for you. It wasn't done on a computer. It was done on his cell phone, and you ought to know that. But you had to be dirty, and you had to be bad. But having said that, bringing...
It was a laptop.
That was God speaking. Oh, God has just clarified.
Yes.
Are you going to deny God?
Oh,
don't
damn
be like
right
all those
I
other
am. Damn right I am.
Typical Democrat.
All right, okay.
Now who's Wiener?
No, you know, I happen.
Now, who's Wiener's
wife? I got
wife
10 minutes
there?
Left to live.
What? Uma. As Chuck calls her, Uma.
Yeah.
You know something?
Is
you
she
know
still
how bizarre
alive?
This
I haven't
guy
seen
is.
Her. Has Hillary killed her?
What?
Did Hillary bump her off? Because I haven't seen her on the news.
You keep it up, you're going to end up on Miscellany Blue tomorrow, okay?
No. Hey, I happen to agree with you. What the hell is this guy, Weena?
Yeah.
She gave him
He's
a chance.
He's best buddies with your nominee.
Oh, that's bull. That's, no, not
she
at all.
She is.
No. Who?
No, the wife. Weiner's wife.
Yeah, who's divorcing him?
We supposedly. Now the election's over, we'll see what happens.
Yes, allegedly.
See, why are you guys this way?
What do you mean?
The guy's a freak.
That runs in the inner circle of the Clinton family.
What?
Why would they hang out with a pedophile?
Yeah, let me see. Clinton. Oh, wait a minute. He's considered one of the best presidents in the last, 50 years?
And who says that?
More
CNN?
More jobs.
Yeah, I've only heard that on MSNBC.
More money.
CNN.
No U.S. debt. Gee,
you know what?
You guys,
you know what? Maybe I'll push back a little bit on that. Maybe.
The manufacturers pick him as the best president.
Yeah.
But you know, you want to know why Clinton's popular in some circles? It's because he was a moderate. It's because he actually cared about the other half of the country that didn't vote for him. Unlike our current president, who went way too far to the left, and then country said, oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Here's the president of Donald Trump to be served up.
No. There is a book out written by, I'm sorry, I just finished it. It's about a gentleman... growing up, and I think...
How many pages was it?
The Kentucky... Oh, don't give me that. How many pages?
How many pages was it?
I don't know, 200 and something.
How many days did it take you to read it?
Why are you doing this?
650,000 emails in 8 days. I'm just curious as to how many pages you read.
Well, I'll tell you what. If I put four words like, let's see, what would I put?
Crooked?
Dog. A dog for Kentucky.
Corrupt.
And I put it in there, and I said, it is an algorithm. You come up with anything about dog, and they could probably do it in 5 minutes. So what is your point? I'm trying to make a point for you guys.
I'm listening.
I'm trying to help you.
Yes. Not that we need
he
it.
He writes
we'll
a very important book where he grew up in, like, Kentucky, the you know, the coal thing and everything, and what he went through. And he finally got out of it. But he never really left it. I mean, the people committing suicide, people doing drugs, people shooting each other. I mean, really bad life. Yeah. And he writes this incredible book. So he came on the other night, and he's talking. He said, hey, it wouldn't have made any difference what she would have done. They lost their jobs. Cole's not coming back. Never is coming back.
Oh, I think it is now.
Oh, why would it come back?
Because it needs to. It's America.
It's an inexpensive energy source that doesn't need to be subsidized by the government.
Are you guys crazy?
You know what's crazy?
Coal is the worst, the dirtiest product.
You know what's crazy?
We have more
natural
gas in the world.
How many?
We have more oil in the world.
How many people?
And you want to do
it. Why don't we use it?
How many people live in the United States right now?
35 million?
Yeah.
Okay, right? Yes. So decent-sized population. What difference does all of your climate change initiatives make if the United States and a couple countries in Europe are the only ones participating? If you got 1 billion people in China, you got 1 billion people in India, you got 500 million in Russia.
China is in it. My son lives in China.
I heard they're putting a coal plant online every week.
What he used to show us, Skyping us, how things have changed.
Does he live in Beijing? Can he send me a picture of the smog right now? You can't even see 4 feet in front of him.
No, actually, he lives probably 100 miles.
Remember the Olympics just not only a couple years ago when the TV cameras were showing the smog, like the pollution in those countries?
That was before because they shut everything down and everything was clear.
My point being is it is an economic disadvantage for this country if we're the only ones trying to keep up with these green energy policies and shutting down our inexpensive fuel sources. That's the problem. You get buy-in from the world, all of a sudden, maybe we can play nice. But if you know,
that sounds really nice. But the problem is it costs a hell of a lot more to dig it and to process it, all right, to get it to wherever, than it does for natural gas. Coal companies are going out of business because, hey, they can't make a profit. So what are you saying?
It's because of Obama.
No, so what are you going to do? You're going to put them back and you're going to what?
Let them compete.
They can't.
Why not?
If we take the regulations away, we can. The
regulations are what's
making it difficult. No, they can't because it costs too much to take it up.
Natural gas is in abundance.
Okay, so you're going to do what? Put coal back?
Take a look at New Hampshire.
Are you going to give them coal?
You're going to give them money to...
Why is Eversource so expensive in New Hampshire? It's because we made them buy a $450 million mercury scrubber to put on their coal facility, which now translates into our electricity rates. Eversource's rates would be much more competitive if they didn't have to deal with that burden.
I have a question. You don't think that that's a good idea?
What?
Do you think it's okay to have this pollution go up and...
I'm in favor of wind and hydro and solar, but I'm not in favor of them when we have to go and pour all sorts of money.
So now you're not really in favor of coal because coal does.
I'm in favor of what's the most inexpensive fuel.
Is natural gas
because people are
the wind actually.
It's not.
No, I know. I'm sorry. I'll take that back. It's not. No, you're right.
Now, I was listening to Hannity on the way down here.
You know, this one person I hate. This guy's really an idiot, and I'm surprised he's got a job.
He's on for hours a day.
I know. He's on. He's out. I'll bet you he's fired within 6 months.
No.
I doubt that. Yeah.
Megyn Kelly will be.
she's done.
And she's good looking. I can say that now. She is very attractive.
No, she won't.
Are you assaulting her right now?
No. she won't.
Yes. No, I have my safety. I have my safety pin.
Where's the safe
space?
They're
working on a new contract right now, and Megyn Kelly is not going to go anywhere.
See, Megyn Kelly is an extremely good looking lady, but I don't like her rant on Trump. And I have my safety pin, so we're all safe, me saying that. But I was listening.
Excuse me. All right. I love you. Tell me what she said. What was the question?
It's her constant beat up of Trump.
No. Let's hear the question that started the whole thing. She asked Trump what question?
She asked about his comments about women.
About women.
Yeah.
Calling them fat. Pigs, ugly.
But she was wrong.
And on, and she says, oh, no. Not only
Rosie O'Donnell.
He says, yes. And he only said it about Rosie
like
O'Donnell.
Question, and then what did he do the next day? He said, well, you know, she had blood coming out of this.
Here's my question to you, though. Here's my question to you.
Yes, go ahead.
We all get angry at one another, right? There's guys that I've said, you know, mean, nasty things about in a fit of disliking them. It doesn't mean I'm anti-man.
Is it because they hit you?
I mean, did they hit me?
You didn't say anything nasty. When I say nasty things, I take a swing.
Well, no, I mean, if you say a guy's fat and ugly and an ass and blah, blah, blah.
You'd say that?
I'm just saying. I've said it about
personal. Have you said that?
About people? Absolutely.
Excuse me, have you ever said...
I've said mean things about people.
I am a state representative, and because I have such power, I can get women to do anything I want. Have you ever said that?
No, I disagree.
Have
no,
you
I've
heard
never said that,
that anywhere?
But I've heard a lot of people.
Oh, wait a minute. Excuse me, a minority president did it.
I've heard a lot of people that get on their high horse that have said stuff like that in my presence.
Who?
I'm not going to go and reveal their names. They're cowards, in my opinion, because they do have. There is a lot of locker room talk, especially up at the Capitol.
In the bathroom.
Especially up at the Capitol.
Capitol in the...
Locker room talk.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Especially some of our senior members that have been up there for a long time have some potty mouths on them and say some really, really, really over-the-top
and
stuff.
I heard it happen to
Democrats
women
and Republicans.
Like what
if I ever
Trump
brought...
Said.
Oh, you know what? Maybe this term I'm going to bring my little speaker in there and hold it around and see what I can
Nothing like Trump said. That was
all. I bet you.
And then 11 women come up.
Someone could follow me around with a microphone for days and never hear me say anything remotely close to what Trump said. But the point is,
your
is
whole
a lot
life
of...
because you're not that way. Do you have a daughter?
Two daughters.
Yeah, you'd never say that.
Yeah, no.
Do you have any children?
Yes.
That's just the way
daughters?
I. Yep.
You'd never say that.
Nope.
I got a son. I'd never say that.
That's
oh, excuse
that's
me.
Us. That's
I'm
us.
Not rich and famous.
That's us. But there's a difference between saying, oh, Trump, what Trump has said is such an outlier to anything I've ever heard from these other prominent people in politics here in this state. And they all get on their high horse and say, I could never, ever, ever back this person. But yet, I know from personal conversations or being around their personal conversations that some of them feel have had conversations that are even dirtier than what Trump said.
Okay. I haven't had it. You have. Have you heard conversations like that? As bad as Trump did?
Close.
Oh, close, but not. But the problem was the recording was not just the words, it was the attitude of what he did, is what he said. That wasn't. Okay, all right, let's put that aside because he won.
Yes. All right. Well, but I wanted to say
what
this caller called in. This, you know, sounded like a young woman called in, and she goes, you know, the biggest reason I voted against Trump, and she says, and I'm a Democrat, is because he's going to bring jobs. And I'm thinking, and the Hannity had a host that, you know, wasn't Hannity. And he goes, and what's the problem with that? Well, because it's going to cause pollution. And I'm going, really? Now, this is from your side.
Yeah, I know, but you don't want to know some of the things. And you want to know something? Reporters were going out and doing this to everybody.
I have another.
There was a couple.
I have another example for you. Another example for you, okay? In terms of the mindset that we have here. I have a friend that I've known for a number of years, didn't vote for Trump. She's not from the United States of America. Moved here about 15 years ago.
Well, she can vote for Trump.
No, she's a citizen.
All right, okay.
She's a citizen. Moved here from another country about 15 years ago. Been friends for a while. We were friends on Facebook. She recently decided that anybody that voted for Donald Trump could not be a good person. Because, in her mind, they absolutely 100% were misogynist, sexist, blankety-blank. Here's my question. This friend of mine comes from a country, okay, in a cultural system where she had an arranged marriage, and all of a sudden, she's telling me that I'm sexist and misogynist when she comes from a country that has long-standing, extremely sexist and misogynist views. That, to me, shows that there's such a lack of understanding in terms of what those concepts actually mean.
You know what your problem is, and I've got to. I always single in on what some of the Republicans do. What you're saying is this: you're comparing this lady, who came and didn't vote for, against the president of the United States. She's not the president.
Oh no! My point being is that she said to me, in effect, that I was irredeemable because I voted for Donald Trump.
And she came from what type of a country?
She came from India.
And oh, India!
Yeah.
Oh, India's awful to their women.
Yeah, but that's my point.
Probably
that's
the
my
worst.
Point. Is that?
Well, would that make I wouldn't her say afraid? The worst. Would that make her afraid if she heard someone say that something like that?
So something like what? Well, my point being is how. Coming from her background, for her to tell me that I was irredeemable because of the vote that I cast for a two-party system.
She came up to you and said that.
This is what she said to me in a private message.
Okay, so are you still talking with her?
No, she defriended me.
You know something? I got to tell you something.
I wish her well, though.
I know. I got to tell you guys something. I want Republicans, and I've got a lot of Republicans that I talk with. I never say anything bad. I never say anything bad. I want to talk. I want to hear what everyone is doing.
But you're an outlier compared to the mainstream party.
Don't call me a liar.
Outlier. But my point being
I don't know what you're talking about.
Is that we used to be able to have discussions about illegal immigration and talk about different ways that we thought that we might be able to fix the borders or get rid of people that were here illegally. And then it became all of a sudden over the last like 4 to 6 years, it became if I brought up even the concept of my opposition to illegal immigration, all of a sudden, I'm a racist, and I don't like Latinos.
Excuse me, but let's remember that under the Obama administration, he has put more immigrants out of this country than any 3 or 4 presidents. 2 million, I think. Trump can't do that good, unless she keeps up the same thing. But I hear what you're saying.
I don't have the numbers, but political discussion and debate has been lost. Hillary Clinton has stood on the floor of the Senate, as has Harry Reid, and called for the construction of a wall and increased border security in the early 2000s. In the 90s, Bill Clinton was a major proponent of getting rid of illegal immigration. And all these people now, it's like the mindset has changed as a result of
He's getting good. You're getting a lot better. You've been doing TV or something?
I've been waiting. I've been sitting out TV.
This is good. Okay, go ahead. Finish.
No, but all of a sudden, we're not having actual debate anymore. We're just casting isms and ists at one another. And that completely shuts down the discussion.
Which brings us to our next subject. You do realize that this right here is probably the freest form of communication. TV.
Oh, yes.
All right. Now, Trump kept saying the media is bad. The media is bad.
Well, mainstream.
The media is bad. Why is it so bad if he got $500 million worth of free ads? How could it be so bad? How could he win so good?
This is what's funny. If you read the most transparent election we've ever had because of WikiLeaks and the emails they provided. Yes. If you take a look.
Oh yeah, that's right. They stole him. The Russians stole them and gave them to WikiLeaks.
It wasn't the Russians.
So who cares?
Regardless
about
of whether they were stolen, isn't it more important if they're true?
True? How would you know what is true?
Well, Donna Brazile got fired. I don't see John Podesta saying that.
Actually, she didn't get fired.
I don't see John Podesta saying that his emails were faked. I don't hear Neera Tanden saying her emails were faked.
Look, I had somebody say to me.
But here's about
what was
Podesta.
Just in the union leader today?
Oh, about the UNH. UNH conspiring with the DNC to help Hillary Clinton.
Yeah.
What a shame. UNH was conspiring.
Yeah, members of the faculty and administration.
Are you sure?
Absolutely.
They quoted the guy from what's that school?
The Cleary or
yeah, the Cleary.
Casey School of.
Yeah. He says, I can help you in my personal life, but how can I help you through UNH, the school?
This is what he.
On his UNH email address.
Yeah, but you know what's very odd about that? College is by nature a liberal.
Explains why we have all these young kids.
The big idea.
But we have
in
rules
the streets
and laws
laying down before traffic
right
now.
I have a question. You believe in because
well,
this
I want to go back one question because you asked
you
about.
You better hurry up because
I'm going
to
hurry
up.
But you just asked why does Donald Trump hate the media? We got 500 whatever you said, whatever your number you pulled out of the air was about all the free coverage you got. If you take a look at the DNC hack and the Hillary Clinton staff hack, it was part of their plan to go to their contacts at CNN, NBC, CBS, and prop up Donald Trump's candidacy for the White House. The idea was, he's the easiest guy for us to beat if he gets in the general. Hillary got her nightmare answered when Trump all of a sudden became the nominee and then went on to beat her. So it was her own messaging to her contacts in the media that backfired tremendously on her.
So do you think the media should change in any way?
I think that if you want to be a lean right or a lean left media outlet, That's great. Do that.
Do you think it should change?
If you want to be someone...
Do you think it should change?
Yes.
I don't,
to a point.
How would you change it?
I think there's a market for an actual right down the middle, non-partisan media filter.
Yeah, like something not like Fox and something
I'm not
CNN.
And tell
something
you.
Right in between.
Right. I'm not going to tell you that Fox News
would you,
is
would you
not
pass
partisan.
A law to make it so?
No.
Would you pass a law like they have in England, slander law?
We have one.
Okay, would you make it stronger?
No.
Good for you. You want to know, I'm going to tell you a story, and this is Bill Maher. Bill Maher got sued by Trump. He had an argument with Trump, and Trump couldn't prove something. So Bill Maher said, well, you can't prove your mother did not have sexual relations with an orangutan. True. Trump sued him for millions of dollars.
Yeah.
Okay? He's at this tiny little station. Firing him will be easy. All right? It goes to court. Guess who wins?
Who?
Probably the news.
Bill Maher. You can say anything that you want. Question. Now he's going to put a couple judges, Supreme Court.
Yeah.
All right? Do you think that the Constitution, the amendment, there may be an amendment to the amendment of the Constitution to cap media, because he's still doing it. We're all bad.
No.
Cap media what?
I don't see
would you do that?
No.
The problem is
no,
is
no,
that,
I'm asking you, would you go along with something like
absolutely
that?
Absolutely not. No. I don't believe in any of these righteous causes to get rid of the quote-unquote fake news. I don't
believe in
increasing the slander laws so it's easier to sue news broadcasters for saying mean things.
So
it's First Amendment.
Okay, so I can say what Bill Maher said.
Yes.
Okay. But let me tell you a little something, because it's very important. The first thing that happens with people like Putin, all right, and heading towards Trump, because Trump loves Putin. He knows how to take care of the media. Yeah, kill him. Close down. Anyway, no, I want to... That's true. That's just not
our business is not what Vladimir Putin does in his own country. Our business is peace for the American people.
Well, when you got a guy who says that that Putin is a good, strong leader.
He is a strong leader.
He's a dictator, for God's sakes. He kills people if they get along. He's, I'm good at that.
But he's proven himself to be a strong leader of the Russian people.
Excuse me. He kills them if they don't do what they do.
That's up to the Russian people to do something about.
Oh, okay, but they don't have the media. So what do they do?
They know about it.
But all this, like, McCarthy-Russia fearism that's going on right now?
You guys can't take that. That's one thing you can't take.
Well, because I'm sick and tired of paying for Europe's defense against a country that poses no threat to me.
Second Amendment, okay, is what? Guns?
Right to bear arms.
So I think there should be a law that all guns that are not in use in a home should have a lock on it. Do you agree?
No.
Why?
Because I want easy access.
So you believe really strong that, right?
Yes.
Okay. Right here, right now, I'm going to say something to you, and this is going to be the truth. He's going to do something with the media that is going to hurt even this show and your show.
He's
going to put up a law. He's going to be able to pass it. And you know what's going to happen? People will come along and say, I don't like John Burt. I'm going to sue the station because John is there. But if they fire John and a lawyer takes the case, are you gone?
I probably would be, but I don't see it happening.
There's a new law there.
But I don't see it happening.
You're just saying that that's going to happen.
So my point is this. Should you be as strong with the First Amendment as you are with the Second Amendment?
I am. And that's why the Second is there, is to protect the First.
If your person started going after the First Amendment, just little tiny clicks away.
But he's not going to.
You're good.
The Bill of Rights is in place to not protect majorities, but protect the minorities in the country. That's what the Bill of Rights is all about. So we were just recently in the minority for a very long period of time. So we're very, very sensitive to the fact that those amendments need to stay in full force, including the First Amendment.
I promise you it's going to happen, and I'm expecting you guys to get behind this because I'll tell you, you guys know that. I talk about the freedom of public access television. We can say things. Actually, we can say more, but there's kind of restrictions here, and that's fine. I don't want to swear or take my clothes off or anything like that.
Yeah, we don't want you either.
That'd be awful.
No, if Trump takes our First Amendment rights away,
hold on a second. That's not how it works. It works with a little bit of truth.
Oh, like what you guys do with gun laws.
But just a tiny little bit of...
What you guys do with gun laws.
Of what?
What, the same playbook that you use
Bloomberg
to take away
does.
Second Amendment rights.
Yeah.
Not you personally, but Democrats in general.
So I'm kind of missing if you want to...
Well, you're saying that you use a little granular of truth,
you know,
in some good cause, but the underlying...
Well, never let a cause, a
crisis go to
crisis
waste.
Go to
personally,
waste.
If I was you guys and you really wanted gun safety, there is, as we know, and a guy got ran out of town, there's a gun that you can just put your thumbprint on it, it goes on automatically, you can shoot it, I can hand it to you, and you can't shoot it. Simple. There can be three or four prints on it, your wife's, and all like that. You can leave it here, you don't have to hide it, you can get it faster. Would you do that?
No. I don't own a gun.
Would you do
if
that?
If I owned a gun, I would get a safe. But that doesn't mean that I can go and then, as the government, step in and say, just because I feel this is what's right for me, I'm going to force this on everybody
else. If somebody breaks into your house and steals your gun and commits a crime and kills someone, are you guilty?
Absolutely not.
Why?
Why? If someone steals your car and runs somebody over with it, are you guilty?
I'm talking about a gun that
shoots. I'm talking about a dangerous vehicle. France killed 82 people.
You know something? Yeah, and I know. If you put too much water on a person, they drown. Look, we're talking about guns.
But it's the same
item. But isn't it funny how you... And, you know, ladies and gentlemen, if we keep talking about this, we'll get down to rocks. Now, and after a while, it'll be sand. Pillows with, you know.
Now, how do you feel about me going to Massachusetts with my gun, which is going to be allowed in the next couple years?
Look, I'm the only Democrat that I think you know that has voted for everything.
Are you going to vote for constitutional carry again?
Except carrying a gun without a permit. And it's simple. The way things are going, I would like a cop, if he stops you, say, are you carrying?
And it's none of his business.
And you can say, well, if he thinks you're drinking and stuff like that, and he can see beer bottles in the back, should he be really
careful?
That poor
gentleman out in Minnesota last year, the African-American, he told the police officer he was carrying a gun, and he got shot for it. Yeah. So I'm not sure where I disagree with that statement. I think it puts police officers on edge.
You know, why do you guys take this one or two things that happen and you build it up? Because
this poor guy was trying to alert the officer that he had a weapon on him, and the guy shot him.
No, he was on a drug and everything. Look, I agree with you. I saw it. I heard his wife yelling, don't know it. He's okay. Look, stop it. Take things that happen now. Because if we don't, if we keep going back and start talking about how bad the media is, you guys got to turn around, especially being elected officials, and say, I don't care, Donald, you can say that all you want, but somehow that media got you elected.
They did.
Only because people found out what the media was doing to prop up Hillary Clinton. That enraged
people.
No,
it's because this guy knew how to, for God's sakes, he was calling up people when he was younger, telling these news people how great Trump was, and it was Trump calling.
I shed no tears for the media because the media got themselves in this situation.
Oh, yes.
I laugh every day when Donald Trump doesn't have his press pool, when they won't let him eat his steak dinner, he won't let him take photos of him or meet with the Prime Minister of Japan, I should have a tear of joy. Okay, it makes me happy.
Say that again?
I get happy when Donald Trump shuts out the media because they're getting what they deserved.
Excuse me.
When he talks about rigged elections, what he's talking about.
So, are you saying that by him not taking the media like other people, by him not taking the media, that's good?
If they're not going to be fair and balanced.
Excuse me, that's good.
When he does it to CNN and NBC, absolutely.
Is that good?
Absolutely.
All right, so.
I wouldn't want the Concord Monitor following me around every day.
And do you want transparency?
I wouldn't want the Nashua Telegraph
following
me around.
How do you get transparency?
Transparency or lies?
Wait.
How can you get transparency?
But why can't the guy go and have a steak dinner with his family?
You can have transparency.
Excuse me?
Oh, the media.
Last 2 days.
CNN and MSNBC, I'm shocked
even
they're
Fox
still
News
on the air.
Hold on, guys. Hold on a second. The most important person in the world? I'm sorry, guys. He can't do this anymore.
CNN is a balanced news site?
Far better than
Do you think
Fox.
It's left?
And you want to know something?
Do you think it's a leftist news site or a right news site?
I watch Fox for Megan to see what she's going to do. And she's been getting beaten up a lot.
But do you think CNN leans to the left?
No.
You don't?
No.
Oh, my God.
I turn on CNN every day since the election's taken place. And every single day they got someone new on there, one of their journalists telling me how racist I am for voting for Donald Trump.
Will you stop it?
It's true.
Just please stop it.
Have they apologized for giving questions during the debates?
You want to know something? They're not don't take it personal.
This
person is not looking through the TV and talking to you.
Oh, they are.
He's talking to a good pot who are racist.
Do you think,
you want to look up?
David Brinkley or Walter Cronkite or Peter Jennings would say half the stuff that's being said on these network medias right now about Republicans?
Excuse me.
Yeah.
If he ever heard a tape of what Trump said on that. All right, boss, he had so much power, that man wouldn't have been president. Is that what you want?
So even PBS was exposed in the WikiLeaks emails, allowing Hillary Clinton to ask them to remove a preview that they had done of her. They wanted her to take it off the air, and they did. That's even PBS, a government-funded station. There's just no journalistic integrity anymore.
I can't believe you're just pulling things out. Look,
I read a lot of WikiLeaks emails.
Look, I've had some things that somebody said.
Yeah.
Right here, good friend, and Richard knows it. At the end of the show, this person left, and I went, Richard, please cut it out because that can't get on the air. All right?
Yeah.
All right? I asked him to take it out, and I'm sure he did because it was awful. So if she said, hey, look, my dress was down, or someone
but
in the back was using their middle finger. Can you take it out? Is that okay?
No.
No.
They should blur it. Okay. If there's a middle finger, blur it.
All right. But the WikiLeaks show just how much connectivity there is between the establishment.
Stop with the WikiLeaks.
I can't. What? You want to talk about why did I get? Why they didn't lie?
The WikiLeaks said that this Podesta was
Spirit
going
cooking?
To what?
Spirit cooking.
What they didn't tell you was he was invited. You get invited to stuff?
Not spirit cooking.
No.
You can tell a lot about people by the people they hang out with.
Yes.
Okay, and if they're slaughtering goats.
Oh, my God. Then we don't want to talk about Trump then. And by the way, I love this. Ladies and gentlemen, Trump just opened what in Washington?
Hotel. Yeah.
He's paid $200 million for it.
Yeah.
To rent it, right?
What's wrong with that?
So, a couple of hotel chains said, no, look, he can't make that money, so he's going to go back to you and say, no, let's renegotiate. But the problem is that we bid for it, he's going to put money into it, and you're going to have to, deal. It just came out 2 days ago that they not only want to bring it down to $28 million, they want some money back that they put into it. Hold on a second here. Exactly, that's how he operates. That's your money.
I haven't read about that yet. I'll go check it out.
Now, what do you think about the protest in Portland, Oregon, that 70% of the hundreds that got arrested, somebody apparently has a lot of time on their hand, they checked their voting record, and 70% of the protesters did not vote?
Hold on a second. You're talking to the wrong person. I am old enough when in the 1960s, I was a bartender in Boston. I'm sorry. I don't know if you guys realize bartenders really have a good time and know what's taking place. I know what marching is.
What year
march
in the
against
60s?
The war. Oh, God. This had 64, 65, 66, 67. Hey,
I was 4 years old.
You
then.
Guys missed the 60s.
Just to point that out.
Find someone who was in the 60s because that area, late 50s, early 70s, was 14 years of an incredible landing on the moon, ended the 60s. All right. Okay. I got to tell you something. I have to take your side to a degree because there was stuff I didn't like.
With Hillary?
The whole thing. I sat there and I watched all the stations. I tried not to yell at the TV. And I saw how some of these things were sliding through, where there were moments where Fox was more on than MSNBC.
Oh, the MSNBC didn't want to give up.
Okay. All right, we got 6 minutes left. Anyway, yes, that goes fast, huh?
Yeah. It does. It does indeed.
No, they didn't want to give up
hope. Can we do 2 hours? I mean, come on. Ask God. God, can we do another half hour?
No.
No, there we go.
No, I went to bed at 11:15.
Why didn't you stay up?
Well, my wife was down there pulling her hair out, and I'm saying, Phyllis, I don't put myself through this. And she goes, well, how do you know if you won? I said, I don't know. I'm assuming I'm going to win, so I go to bed. I wake up at 3 o'clock, and she's not there. And I'm going, where is she? So I hear her downstairs. I go downstairs, and she's looking at the TV. And I said, what are you doing? And she goes, I want to turn the TV on, but I can't. I can't do it. And I said, why? So we turned it on, and there's Trump giving the speech.
Good.
And at first, I thought he lost.
So he won.
And then she reads the bottom.
All right, I got to go. We got to do an extra 10 minutes because there's a couple things I really, really want to say.
All right, well, ask her.
But I just forgot what they were.
You only have a 1 hour slot.
Oh, God. All right.
It's a show after me.
Look.
Now, was it?
I know
what you wanted to say.
What?
You wanted to look at the camera and say, America, Al Baldessaro is right.
I never want to say that, even when he is right. I have to eat his parakeet next week. I can't believe he's going to kill his own parakeet for me to eat on the air. You believe that?
Now, I got a chicken if you want.
No. You do have a chicken. That's for sure. Hey, look, I got in a fight at the polls. There was some really yahoos with the Hillary, go to jail, all that stuff.
Yep.
But the problem was there was this young lady who was 19, 20 who had a sign up and said, hey, guys, could you kind of keep it down? I mean, you bump it. Sit down or shut up. Her mother comes up to me and says, you're my alderman. You're my state rep. I'm going to vote for you. I said, okay. This is what they said to my daughter. I said, oh, how many are there? 5 or 6. Oh, that's okay. I take my sign, I go down there, I yell in his face, shut up! He yells, the Constitution. I says, okay, don't hit her, right? Big guy comes out, 5. I says, there's only 5 of you. Of course, I was very brave because a cop was walking right behind him. All right, so Big argument. Anyway, the guy throws the sign down and goes away. Three women come up to me and said, what happened to this nice Ken Gidge who was so kind and gentle, is yelling and screaming? I can't do anything. Anyway, congratulations, you have a minority president. All right, I understand that. And I understand how everything works. And
you mean the majority of electoral college
votes. You want to tell everybody where you're from?
Bedford.
Bedford?
New Hampshire.
Bedford, New Hampshire.
Yep.
And you are second term?
Second term, yeah.
Yes, and you are from?
Goffstown, New Hampshire.
And your name is?
John Burt.
And how can people get in touch with you?
Easy. BurtNH.com is my website. Facebook, John Burt. Or give me a call at 624. What is my number? 5084.
Yeah, that's
624-5084
right.
Okay. Is my he's home
been
number.
Sucking his ear before.
Well, I never right, call
how
myself.
How can they get in touch with you?
You can go to my website at www.voteforbart.com, and you can reach me by email at bart@voteforbart.com.
And I have said this, that you are in commerce, and you and I had one of the great fights with both Republicans and Democrats.
We did.
Remember that?
We did.
We didn't let go.
We did not.
We lost. All right, my name is Ken Gidgen, and listen, let's just try to get along, I guess. Let's just see how things go. But, of course, this gives me a great moment to have a lot of fun, and I know I got to wear the safety pin. All right. But I'm telling you right now, and I want you to know this, very shortly you're going to see an attack slightly on the media. It's going to happen, the First Amendment. And if these gentlemen right here will fight for the First Amendment.
We will.
We will.
Much. Now, you remember, you do not want, you know, locks on your guns if when they're at home, correct?
I do. I just don't want to force it on other people.
Okay. So anything to change the First Amendment, you're going to fight with?
Yes.
All right, there we go. All right.
We are.
We are.
You have our word. We're big on the Constitution.
Yeah. Okay. Let's talk about what's taking place in the state of New Hampshire besides.
It's a lot of Republican stuff, man.
Yes, I think a lot of good bills are coming forward.
A lot of small government, low spending, probably some agencies getting smaller.
How the hell do you guys say that? We're the cheapest state in the world.
I want to be cheaper.
Get cheaper.
Yes.
We're known as a cheap state.
We are. But we can get cheaper.
Do you know that we were voted the freest state in the
We were.
There's still
States.
Lots of room for improvement, though.
Oh, shut up. Yeah. You guys are going to screw it up. Everybody screws up. They get in and they screw it up. I don't know. I've been on a party that has screwed it up a lot.
No, under the right speaker, and we got a good governor in the corner office, we're golden.
Okay, remember, public access TV is very important.
It is.
Any other place we could not say this, because we get kind of rough, but we kind of like each other, all right? Remember, public access, this is very important. And you do a show?
Yes, New Hampshire Politics, right up in Goffstown.
Yourself?
I sometimes do a show in Bedford, but I can't speak freely there.
Well,
so
you can't speak freely there.
No.
Oh, come down here.
Oh, well, that's why you think I love being here.
Yeah, you go to Goffstown.
You can't speak freely in Bedford?
They're censored there.
We're censored.
Censored?
Yeah. Yes.
You can't talk about politics.
I cannot advocate a political
position. I did that show up there, and they did that.
Yeah.
Yes.
We got to fix that.
Yeah.
Why don't all three of us get together and fix that?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. This is the show directly after the election. Trump did win. He's putting his cabinet or whatever together. It ought to be fun. Thank you, and we will see you next week.
The preceding program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.